these are our different compounds. You can see there's a variety here on the table. Some of these are used as burn compounds. Again, they're used to clean the parts and the media and the operation. And they also enhance the burn. Others enhance burnishing, which is called burnishing compounds. Others are actually used more or less to polish as well. So they have different functions. The key to compounds is understanding the metal you're dealing with. Depending on the metal that's being used or processed, will determine the compound as well. Because certain compounds could actually cause more damage to you. So you need to make sure that you understand your metals and you understand the proper compound to go with that.
And down here we've got something else, looks like a cream, these creams.
Yeah, we have our creams. A variety of creams. We have some creams that are used for strictly for deburring processes. We have some high finishing creams for high luster polishes, especially on plastics. Although they can be used in carved out a walnut shell or polishing metals as well. Mm-hmm.
And the creams are all used with the hardwood medias.
They can be used with hardwood media and also corn-covered walnut shell.
And what would be the difference? Why would you choose to use a corn-cob or walnut shell instead of the hardwood media? What kind of scenario would that make sense for?
It's really, a lot of it is, one would test the part. Some things work better with the walnut shell than the corn-cob. Maybe if there's not a lot of lodging issues, we choose to go that approach. If there's a lot of lodging issues, the pegs are a little more user-friendly because they're less likely to get into the smaller holes. So that's usually what determines it. With plastics, I tend to go with pegs. With metal, I will usually go with the corn-cob walnut shell.